The moons of the outer planets are some of the most intriguing objects in the solar system. On April 13, 2017, NASA released exciting new findings on Europa and Enceladus, two moons that orbit Jupiter and Saturn. Using the Cassini space probe and the Hubble Space Telescope, scientists have repeatedly observed large plumes erupting from the icy surfaces of these moons, an indication of large subsurface liquid water oceans. What's more, the chemical makeup of these plumes suggests a strong likelihood of hydrothermal vents on the moon's ocean floors. Since these kinds of vents support oases of microbial life on the Earth's ocean floor, scientists are understandably excited about the opportunities presented by these findings. It's now up to space agencies to focus some of their efforts on exploring these icy moons. In this video, you'll learn about what's next in humanity's effort to explore these worlds in the near future and beyond, and what we might find there. Since its first close-up photographs in 1979, the cracked icy surface of Jupiter's moon Europa has suggested the presence of a liquid ocean underneath it, inviting speculation about whether or not Europa might harbor life. In contrast, when Saturn's moon Enceladus was first imaged by the Voyager probes, astronomers were surprised by its relatively smooth and craterless surface, suggesting recent geological activity. In the 2000s and 2010s, the Cassini probe performed several close flybys of Enceladus, discovering the presence of water vapor, gradually gathering evidence supporting the theory that it too might harbor a subterranean ocean. Cassini even detected simple hydrocarbons in the plumes venting from its surface, also suggesting the possibility that life could be present there. While space probes have briefly visited these moons since the 1970s, no dedicated missions have been sent to them as of yet. That being said, Enceladus and particularly Europa have been the targets of several proposed missions, ranging from flybys to complex multi-part landers that would melt through these moons' kilometers-thick ice, deploying submarines to explore their icy oceans. Right now, the most likely candidate for the exploration of these moons in the near future is NASA's Europa Clipper, co-developed with the Jet Propulsion Laboratory and the Applied Physics Laboratory at Johns Hopkins University. This robotic spacecraft would orbit Jupiter, aiming to buzz Europa 45 times to image its surface to a resolution of 50 meters per pixel. Because Europa is right inside Jupiter's radiation belt, even a strongly shielded orbiter would only have about 30 days to transmit data back to Earth. But the proposed multiple flyby trajectory would allow it to spend up to a year transmitting its high-resolution information. Since the bandwidth between Earth-based antennas and probes in space is so low, this extra time will allow the information transmitted to be of much higher quality than would be possible with an orbiter, at roughly the same cost. But you'll have to wait a bit longer for a landing to be attempted on Europa in the very near future. While a lander was originally proposed for the Europa Clipper, it was eventually decided to launch it at a later date to save roughly $1 billion on the Clipper mission, a small price to pay if that mission gets expedited. Of course, the most exciting potential mission in the near future is the robotic submarine. Since the crusts of these moons are theorized to be several kilometers deep, the melting apparatus might need to be nuclear-powered to sustain its descent through the thick ice. While most proposals for this kind of probe have targeted Europa, recent discoveries by Cassini suggest that Enceladus's ice shell might be thinner than originally thought, which might increase the political support for a mission there at first. We have no idea what we'll find under the icy surfaces of these moons. It's certain, however, that whatever discoveries we do make will be significant. If these vast oceans are completely sterile, it will tell us much more about the parameters necessary for life to form in the universe. And if we do find life or evidence of life, it will be the most significant discovery in human history. The tools to make this discovery have been in some form of development for years now, and the political will to do so is there. NASA's Europa Clipper has received bipartisan support since it was first proposed, indicating that there is strong interest in exploring these icy moons. Who knows what we might find there? Thank you very much for watching this video. As always, don't forget to subscribe, and if you want to support my channel, contribute to my Patreon here. If you'd like to see more of my space videos, just click this playlist here. And if you'd like to learn about basic computer science, just click here. Your support in the comments has been amazing, and I can't wait to see you in the next video.